Hello, how you doing? I'm Jeffrey Lee Volshinsky, your referee of the monotonous. And I am counting down to three as this show hits your mind with a chair of babble gab and then goes up to the third rope to finish the job. And I am pumped up and ready to rumble as we ask this week's question. Did you know Abraham Lincoln was once a championship wrestler? Yes, you heard that correctly. In his youth, the 16th president of the United States of America and great emancipator was once an avid wrestler. But before you go imagining Mr. Lincoln wearing spandex tights, holding a championship belt over his head after he just pummeled Jefferson Davis in a battle royale, we have to understand what wrestling was back then. And if your mind was more than likely not heading in that direction, and now that's all you can imagine, all I can say is, whoops. Anywho, wrestling back in the pioneering days was more of a friendly contest amongst individuals more than an actual sport. Often referred to as grappling, where two contestants would try to seize one another and then put them in a hold. The match was won when the victor eventually managed to throw the other one to the ground. Rumor was that Mr. Lincoln was so good that in a 12-year period, he was only beat a couple of times, and one of those losses is still hotly debated. You see, in 1830, Mr. Lincoln's boss at the time was so impressed with his new 6'3", highly intelligent employee that he went around boasting that his new hire was the strongest man in town. Well, this didn't sit well with the local gang and their leader by the name of Jack Armstrong, who immediately marched over to Mr. Lincoln's place of business and challenged him to a wrestling match. Lincoln accepted the challenge, and after the match started, Mr. Armstrong found out very quickly that he got more than he bargained for. When it looked like he was going to lose the match, Mr. Armstrong's friends tried to trip up Mr. Lincoln by kicking at his legs. Legend has it that all Lincoln did while this was going on is laugh and make jokes about the whole situation. This, of course, endeared him to the entire group, and even though Mr. Lincoln was eventually thrown to the ground, Mr. Armstrong admitted that the win wasn't entirely on the up and up. The story of this match got out, and Mr. Lincoln was declared the Illinois County Wrestling Champion of 1830. Although this was more of an honorary title, since Illinois didn't have a championship wrestling organization back then. It was said that this match was what made Mr. Lincoln a local celebrity and started his rise to prominence that would eventually find him winning the presidential election 31 years later. In 1992, the National Wrestling Hall of Fame honored Mr. Lincoln with an award that included adding him into their Presidential Grapplers exhibit, alongside the likes of George Washington, John Adams, and Theodore Roosevelt. Just showing you good things can come from rough and tumble beginnings. Okay, I can feel your mind swelling up from the mental beatdown that this show just gave you, so I best just stop there. But before I let you throw in the towel, let me leave you with this bazooka wormhole. The Olympics used to be done in the nude. Just pointing out that no matter what you're doing, showmanship is everything. And with that, I'm Jeffrey Lee Volshinsky saying adios, amigos.